नमो तस्स भगवतो अरहतो सम्मा संबुद्धस्स। गुड इवनिंग फॉर एवरीबॉडीज। यस, हाउ अबाउट योर अभिधम्म नॉलेज? स्टिल रिमेम्बर व्हाट आई हैड टीच? ओके, एनीवे टुडे एक्चुअली वी हैव टू स्टार्ट चैप्टर 3 अकॉर्डिंग टू द अभिधम्म संग्रह। बट बिफोर स्टार्ट चैप्टर 3, आई हैव टू डू द रिविजन क्लास, रिविजन अबाउट चित्त। ओके, कैन आई आस्क सम थिंग रिगार्डिंग चित्त? बट एनी वे एवरीबॉडी हैज़ द नोट, नो नोट्स? ओके, एनी वे, वॉट इज द मीनिंग ऑफ चित्त? या दे हैव द मीनिंग, बट द नेम, द कॉन्सियसनेस, द नेम ऑफ द चित्त, बट वॉट इज द मीनिंग? दे हैव द मीनिंग, द नोइंग द ऑब्जेक्ट। ओके, चित्त इज द मीन नोइंग द ऑब्जेक्ट, टू अंडरस्टैंड द ऑब्जेक्ट, दिस इज मीनिंग। ओके, अकॉर्डिंग टू द लॉर्ड बुद्धास टीचिंग, हाउ मेनी कॉन्सियसनेस, हाउ मेनी चित्त? या दे आर 89 ओ 121। दोज आर कॉन्सियसनेस वी कैन डिवाइड इन टू अकॉर्डिंग टू द प्लेसेस, द प्लान, द प्लेन। Now they have the notes, classification of chitta according to the planes. The Pali we call bhumi, bhumi, bhumi is a place actually, sphere. Sense sphere consciousness, fine material sphere consciousness, immaterial sphere consciousness, supermundane consciousness. Now you can see the how much in briefly and in details. Okay? According to the 54 sense sphere, kamavachara chitta, there are 54 kamavachara chitta, we can divide into three parts, three categories. What are the three? Akusala chitta, unwholesome consciousness. What is the meaning unwholesome? And akusala. Yes, what does it mean, akusala? This is bad, bad thing. And if someone doing the bad, it is akusala. Someone doing the wrong, it is also akusala. Someone doing anything bad by verbally, by action, by bodily or by mentally, this is akusala. Okay? Now, there are how many akusala chitta? 12. Okay? They have the details. Next, ahetuka chitta. Ahetuka. Ahetuka. Yeah, rootless. Good. Rootless. Hetu is a rootful. Ahetuka. In front of hetu, in front of a. If put the a means actually na hetu. Na hetu, na big change to a, according to the grammar. Na hetu, don't have hetu. Then we use the ahetu. Okay? Rootless. Same way, kusala. Na kusala, become akusala. Don't have kusala, don't have wholesome. That's why you call akusala. The na change to according to Pali grammar. Okay? The some place we can see. There's a, then this hetu meaning root full. Ahetu rootless. Now this is ahetuka chitta, rootless consciousness. Ahetuka chitta. Hetu is a root, hetuka rootful, ahetuka rootless. Okay, there are how many? 18. Sobana chitta, sobana, beautiful. So one is beautiful. Beautiful consciousness. There are 24. Okay. What are the 12 type of unwholesome consciousness? What are the 12? 12 type of unwholesome consciousness also we can divide into according to roots. The lobha mula, rooted in greed consciousness. Dosa mula, rooted in hatred. Moha mula, rooted in delusion. Okay? Understand? Okay, now the first eight. Consciousness rooted in greed, greedy, lobha mula chitta. What are the eight? Now I think you remember. I no need to recite, no? Yeah. But anyway, you can see the meaning. The next page. One consciousness accompanied by pleasure associated with wrong view unprompted. The example, someone after seeing beautiful house or beautiful car, oh, it is very nice, oh, it is very good, then he attached to this object. Then after seeing the beautiful house or beautiful car, he's very happy. This is a pleasure. Accompanied by pleasure, but at that time he attached, and he won't. It is belongs to me. I want to get, because of this mind, the wrong view. Okay, nobody tell him to take this object. He take by himself. This is a unprompted. Okay, but every day, if someone can. Reflect your mind, what I had done today and after wake up until sleep. So many unwholesome things you can see. Almost unwholesome consciousness. Very rare to find the wholesome mind in our daily life. Yeah, because sometimes some people want to offer dana. Okay, on the offering for the monk. At that time, they cannot do the with pure mind. So sometimes they think, oh, if I offer this one, Bhante eat or not? This one suitable or not? Or maybe, oh, Bhante didn't touch in my plate. This is akusala, not the kusala. Because you are not happy. This is a hatred. That's why. But there's a Lord Buddha mentioned, if someone doing the wholesome, you have to think before offering, then during the offering moment, after offering. All the time you should make with pure mind. Happiness with happy mind. But not the greedy. This is a non-greedy mind. Okay? This is practically you have to apply in your daily life when you are doing good thing. Sometimes the last time we done the Katina ceremony, so many people. Maybe that you want to offer, but have the queue number. Sometimes you cannot wait until your queue number. Arising those are mine, that's why the difficult to continue the wholesome mind in our daily life, okay? Practically you can think. Practically you try to apply your life. But this Abhidhamma is not the counting method. The someone thing, this is counting method. We have to count how many mental factors arise with this mind, this mind, this mind. This is not the counting method. But we have to count. But those are things we have to apply in our daily life. How we overcome from the akusala? How we overcome from our difficulties with kusala mind? Okay? We have to, all the time, we have to practice. This is the Abhidhamma. Because Abhidhamma is the ultimate reality. We cannot see by eye. We cannot listen by ear. But everything we investigate by our mind. This is Abhidhamma. Not the, because sometimes if you want to listen some sutta, they have example. But Abhidhamma also difficult sometimes give the example. The Abhidhamma is because we are talking about the nama rupa, the mentality of materiality. Nama rupa. Okay? That's nowadays some people don't want to study Abhidhamma. They say, oh, very difficult, very difficult, very difficult to understand. Somebody complained, Abhidhamma is not the Buddha's teaching. This is latest one. But why, if someone cannot understand, after that, they're going to blame for the Buddha's teaching. But anyway, we have to think Abhidhamma is not the counting method, not the book method. Abhidhamma is a philosophy, one side, one of the philosophy. And we have to investigate by our life, by our mind. You can understand by your daily life. Especially, who want to meditate? Who are the meditating? Those are people can understand what is the importance of the Abhidhamma. That's why we want to think. There are eight types of lobha mind. Now some consciousness arising with prompted. The number third, accompanied by pleasure, disassociate with wrong view. Unprompted. Example. The sotapatti, stream entry, some sotapatti person. Okay? They also attach to the properties. That means attach means not the clinging. Example, how to say the not the attached to the by himself. Example now the visa. I also already explained before. The Visakha. One day he was crying because of die one of the granddaughter. Actually, why she cried? What's the reason? She attached to the daughter, but she not attached to the by him herself. Because she already sotapatti. But in the sotapatti's mind never ever arise wrong view. But arising the attachment mind. This is disassociated with wrong view. The same way, but we can think normally in our life also. The first day, I want to take the new food. Okay? First day, I receive the special. But first day, we enjoy with the food. Very happy. But every day we can get the same food. At that time, we enjoy, but not like before, first day, not like second day. First day, we eat a lot, or maybe we take, this is very good, very good taste. We have a different mind, this is a wrong view. After that, slowly so your mind become normal. Sometimes we call upekka. Sometimes equanimity. Sometimes there is still happiness but no wrong view. But anyway, you have to understand by yourself. Okay? There are eight types of lobha mind. The same way, there are two types of hatred consciousness. One consciousness accompanied by displeasure associated with dosa, aversion, unprompted. And there's another prompted. The example now, after we seen the people, you're angry. After someone doing the bad thing, after seeing you're so angry, very easy to get angry. Now this is anger mind. We can find your daily life, how many times you can see the anger mind in your life, daily life? Within the one day? Many. we have to control. Then the but according to practically, who has the too much anger? If someone difficult to control his anger, he should practice metta meditation all the time. The loving kindness. If someone always greedy for the properties or for the people, whatever. If someone want to control, you should give up, give up. And another last two, the delusion. Equanimity associated with doubt or restlessness. At that time, you should contemplate. You try to stay in one object and you try to develop wisdom and mindfulness to overcome from this the delusion. Okay? The same way, there are... they have the one chart. Unwholesome consciousness. They have the chart for the understand. Pleasant feeling. Yeah. Neutral feeling, wrong view, not wrong view, prompted, unprompted. They have the chart. Okay? Because you should try to focus about the feeling. Because our third chapter is starting from the feeling. Okay? Because later we have to count how many feeling and how we understand the feeling. Okay. Now you see the pleasant feeling associated with somanasa, pleasure. Neutral feeling associated with upekkha. Unpleasant feeling associated with domanasa, displeasure. Okay, next one, rootless consciousness. The 18 type of rootless consciousness also we can make three group. Unwholesome resultant consciousness. Akusala vipaka. If you can see bad thing, bad object, bad color object, sound object, smell object, taste object, tangible object. Because of the bad, arising unwholesome resultant consciousness. Example now, during the Buddha's time, during the lifelong period, at the time, very difficult to find the sick people. Very difficult to see the old age people. Very difficult to see the dead body also. Very rare, very, very rare. Why? Because the human's lifespan very long. Sometimes 60,000, 80,000, 100,000, over 100,000. Okay, in future will appear Maitreya Buddha. During that period, you know how about the human lifespan? 100,000 lifespan. At that period, Maitreya Buddha will appear. But Maitreya Buddha will live in this world 80,000 years. Wonderful, no? You want to see Maitreya Buddha in future? Yeah, that's why. At that time, difficult to see the sick people, dead body, or old age people, difficult. This is wholesome. They are good life. But nowadays, we are all the time listening, seeing all other rubbish, all other bad thing. This is our akusala vipaka. Because after seeing the bad thing arising, akusala mind. After listening, bad thing arising, akusala mind. This is the akusala vipaka all the time rising. That's why now if someone take the bad object all the time arising, akusala vipaka eye consciousness, same way ear, nose, tongue, body. You understand? I remember the one day Sayadawji told us, if someone don't want to get Nibbana in this life, but should not reborn again in the human world, this is a not good period to reborn. You should go to the Brahma world to save your life. Yeah, I remember sometimes Sayadawji told the student. Why? Because now we are still okay. We have still the good friend, the good Dhamma teachers to practice Dhamma. But we don't in future, no? After 100 years or after 200 years, we don't know what happened in this world. No, slowly, slowly, the difficult to practice good way, right way. Example, now you are doing some job in the company. Difficult to keep in good mind in the company. Difficult to stay with the harmonious with the people. Understand? This is our bad reason, bad karma. This is a resultant of the akusala vipaka. This is akusala. Understand? Yeah. Same way, if you can see the good thing in this world about the Buddha, you can listen to the Dhamma, and you can take the good object, at that arising, resultant of wholesome mind. Resultant of wholesome mind. Eye consciousness, ear, nose, tongue, body. Example now, someone every day can see the Buddha, every day can see the Sangha. All that arising, good mind. This is a his good reason. This is a good resultant mind. Okay, this way, then the unwholesome resultant, wholesome resultant, you have to understand. I'm not going to give the detail because I already explained before. Okay? Rootless, functional consciousness, ahetuka chitta, there are three. Five sense door adverting consciousness accompanied by equanimity, mind door adverting consciousness, smile producing consciousness accompanied by joy. There are three important. Actually, the first one, five sense door adverting consciousness, the panchadvara vachana mind, we call manasikara, attention mind. Attention mind, manasikara, and viti patipadaka manasikara, another name, preparing the chitta process. Preparing chitta process. Without fido adverting consciousness, we cannot take object, we cannot appear the chitta process. Eye do, ear do, nose do, tongue do, body do. Okay? Okay, someone reading the book. And then somebody going, coming, going, coming. If you don't pay attention to take this object, that you're not interested to see who is going, who is coming, who is doing. You're not interested. Your mind not, you're only focusing the reading the book. At that time, the attention mind not arising. If you want to see means attention mind arising, then you take the object and chitta process going. This is the fido adverting consciousness we call attention mind or preparation of chitta process. Viti patipadaka manasikara. Then the manodvara vajjana, mind or adverting consciousness. Actually, there are two meanings. One meaning, the according to the Abhidhamma, now we know the yoniso manasikara and ayoniso manasikara, they have two very important sentences. Wise attention and unwise attention, or proper attention or improper attention. Because of this attention arising javana moment. Javana is a kamma. Javana is a kamma. Now we are collecting good and bad karma every day, no? Every moment. If you collect bad karma means because of improper attention. Unwise attention. Because of unwise attention arising akusala karma. Because of wise attention arising kusala karma. You understand? This is a try to apply in daily life also. You can, no? If you want to, that's why the in the commentary explaining how many way to appear the wholesome mind, how many way to appear unwholesome mind. Example now, because of the good object. The Buddha image. This is a very desirable object, no? Because of that, surely appear the wholesome mind. You know the meaning of offering dana. Now, example, the 2 days, 3 days ago, you done the very good kusala kama, we call katina. Now, you know the meaning of the katina? If you know the meaning, if you know the benefit of the katina, that's why we are doing the katina. But some Sri Lankan, the ancient book, explaining about the meaning of the katina. Pavattan sabba dananang katina dana manuttarang aggang punyancha settancha sabba metena labbati. Means the katina dana is the highest offering of material, and whatever you have wishes, everything come truth after offering katina. The same way, Giriraja samang rasing sange deti tichivaran ekasa katina danasa kalan nagadi solisa. My English very poor. I try to explain. the Mahameru mountain. Have you heard how high 84,000 yojana from sea level to the mountain 84,000 yojana. Actually how many miles for one yojana in the ancient time they call 16 miles, but nowadays they count maybe more than 10 miles for the one yojana. Someone offering 8 requisite. You know 8 requisite? Someone offering 8 requisite just like the mountain, the Mahameru mountain. But someone offer one katina. His one katina's benefit, the privileges, higher than offering the 8 requisite. Why? We cannot offer katina every day, once a year. But 8 requisite we can offer every time, any time. And if someone want to offer katina, should spend the first vasa, and after that bhikkhu have to do the pavarana, and don't break the vasa. Then one bhikkhu spend in the one place, he spend the vasa, but you cannot offer katina for the personally. You should offer for sangha. You should bring at least 5 monk, including the vasa bhikkhu. At least 5 bhikkhus. That's why katina ceremony, katina is a very good benefit. They are the highest beneficial. They explain so many things in the explaining the katina. That's how, if you know the meaning of katina, this, you are offering very, very wonderful. The same way, the Raja Chakrava, universal king, he has the one of the gem, the Chakra, circle gem, no? will Jim. If the universal king want to go somewhere, because of this power of the will, he can go everywhere. The same way, if some the other peoples want to follow him, follow the king, universal king, because of the power of the will, everybody can go. Visit the whole the world. The same way, Katina, just like the will of the universal king. But Katina is only one chivara. Only one chivara. But many things inside. Chivara, pindapata, four requisite. Not only Katina chivara, different many, many chivara, eight requisite. And offering food, pindapata. And offering the material thing for the monastery. And offering the medicine, etc. The everybody can get the Katina, the privileges of Katina. That's why the Katina is more higher than the Sri Lankan, the ancient book, the one of the book explaining this the according to the way. Then that's a, if you know the meaning of offering, then your mind become good, highest wholesome mind arising. Very good and the powerful wholesome mind. This is a, that's why if you know the way, how to cultivate the wholesome mind. It is good, okay? Then the manodvara, mind of advert is the proper attention mind, wise attention, okay? Next, last one, the smile producing consciousness only for arahat, who destroy the all taint, asavakya, who has asavakya knowledge. You know asava? There are four types of asava, four types of taint. No taint, no? Taint. Taints. Four times taints. This is defilement, example, defilement. Who destroyed all defilement? He became arahat. This smiling consciousness arises only for arahat, sometimes for the Buddha, for the silent Buddha and for the arahat. Okay? Not for us. If we want to smile, our smile consciousness is different. Sometimes we smile with the greedy mind. Sure? Huh? Sometimes we smiling with a non-greedy mind. But the arahat also is smiling with one of the rootless consciousness. Okay. This one they have chart according to the rootless consciousness. Ahetuka chitta. Equanimity, painful, happy feeling, yeah. Okay. Okay, now about the sobana chitta, beautiful consciousness. There are four types of beautiful consciousness. Yes, four types of beautiful consciousness. Sense fear, beautiful consciousness. Fine material, beautiful consciousness. Immaterial, beautiful consciousness. And supermundane, beautiful consciousness. There are four types of beautiful consciousness. If you want to get beautiful mind, if you want to make the beautiful life, but we are nowadays the nowadays the people think about the beautiful. Okay, so this is a beautiful mind. We have to develop the beautiful mind about the for the beautiful consciousness. Okay, now there are, according to the sense fear, beautiful consciousness, there are three types. Okay, there are three types. The kamavachara kusala chitta, sense fear, wholesome consciousness, there are eight. Sense fear, resultant consciousness, there are eight. Sense fear, functional consciousness, there are eight. Okay, important thing, eight wholesome. 8 also. If you want to get healthy mind, if you want to get happiness life, if you want to get a beautiful life, you should cultivate wholesome consciousness. Okay? There are, what are the 8? 1, consciousness accompanied by pleasure, associated with knowledge, unprompted. Important thing, some wholesome mind arises with knowledge. Some wholesome consciousness arising without knowledge. This is important. Why? You know the 3 rooters consciousness and 2 rooters consciousness. According to this method. Who can cultivate 3 rooters consciousness, he can get the highest benefit. If someone want to reborn in this world again, if someone want to reborn, sure, we have to reborn because we are still ordinary person. We have the next life. If you want to get the fully perfect, good next life, okay, we should cultivate 3 rooters consciousness. This knowledge, with knowledge consciousness, knowledgeable consciousness. Okay. Then that's why in the commentary explain, if someone doesn't know the meaning of what you are doing, better you discuss with your teacher and discuss, Pante, I want to offer juice. Okay, I'm offering the juice. What are the benefits of juice? Pante, I'm offering the porridge for the sangha. I want to know the meaning of the porridge. I'm offering the medicine. Then you can discuss with your teacher. Then teacher can explain their benefit. Then this is very helpful to you to develop your wholesome mind. Then the commentary explained, you should ask from your teacher when you are free, or if you have any dhamma discussing at that time, because the Lord Buddha already mentioned, explained everything. Then, Bhante, I am offering the flowers for the Buddha. They have the benefit or not? Because now, maybe someone thinks, offer flowers only one day. We expend a lot of elaborate requisite, but after that, useless. Can sometimes arise like this mind, no? Very easy. Very easy. But then example now, you make one tent outside for the Katina ceremony. Only for one day, but still, we have spent a lot of elaborate requisite. Useless money. No, can appear like this mind. At that time, you have to control, this is Akusala, you know the King Kosala. King Kosala, he offered Asadisa Mahadana. Asadisa meaning not compared to the others offering. He offers, incomparable offering. Then he make different kind of decoration before offering. In the outside of the palace, he make the very big hall, and he make the Buddha sitting place and other Arahata sitting place different with the flowers, natural flowers and natural the incense, the smell. So many decoration. He spend lot of the elaborate requisite. Okay? Then all the other 5, including Buddha, 500 monks, they are coming for the Pindapatha to the palace. The 2 ministers of the king, the one minister's name is Kala, another name is Junha. The Kala, his mind different. Why the king offer like this thing for the monk? Monk is always stay, they are doing nothing. Because the they are not help for the develop of the country. They stay alone, they practice nothing. Why they offer many things for the Sangha, bhikkhu? Then he got akusala. The junha, he thought, oh, sadhu, sadhu, like this thing can do only for the king. We cannot offer. We are very poor. We know enough allowable requisite for us to support for the sasana. He make happy. Then Lord Buddha check, see the two mind. Then the but king after offering, but the king was waiting. Oh, today I can listen the very good Dhamma talk. But Lord Buddha not explain anything, just leave from the house, from the palace. Then the king got upset. Then after he reported to the Buddha, he asked what's the reason. Then Lord Buddha explained, one of the ministers not happy offering, one of the ministers very happy. Then if I give Dhamma talk, he not respect Dhamma also, not respect to Sangha, not respect Buddha. Surely, definitely, he going to hell. Because of that, I didn't give any talk here. Not explain anything. You understand? No, that's why. But someone doing good thing, someone after taking the object, someone taking the bed. Someone can continuously holding the good mind. Oh, sadhu, sadhu, sadhu. But someone, his property, my property is higher than his property. But the different consciousness can arise in our mind. We should try to control, okay? This is Abhidhamma. This is Abhidhamma, not the other. Why we study Abhidhamma? To understand our mind. That's why you should cultivate the good mind, the three rotors mind. What are the three rotors? Aloba, non-greedy. Adosa, non-hatred means metta, loving kindness. And amoha is a wisdom. Then if you want to, for example, now you brought the food plate. At that, okay, this is a food I buy from the shop or from the restaurant. Anyway, I spend my pure allowable requisite to buy. At that time, this is arising aloba. Then I am going to offer for the monk. Those are food help for the monk to be healthy. May Bante, may Sangha be healthy and well and happy, free for all suffering. They have a lot of loving kindness, my thoughts arising. This is adosa. Then I am offering for the sasana, for the Sangha, this food. Surely I can get the benefit. Surely I can get the Nibbana. This is the wisdom. Then before offering, you have to reflect. This is three rooters consciousness. This is a supporting. Now you have heard about the one of the king in Sri Lanka, Duttagamini. He built the Mahacheti in Sri Lanka. Sri Lanka had one of the very big pagoda, we call Mahacheti. In the commentary also explained in the Mahacheti. Our Lord Buddha's the relic bowl, completely relic bowl inside the pagoda. And same way, he built the 9-floor sima for the monk in the ancient time. Same way, he built the different pagoda also. But the last moment, when he died, last moment, the one of the arahat, we call Thera Puttabhaya, one of the arahat, he's reflecting his what he done during his life. He reflects good thing only, remind him. At that time, he catch only two objects, not the Mahacheti, not the big Sima Hall. He took only two objects. What are the two? One day, he entered the forest with the rice packet. At that moment, one of the bhikkhu coming Pindapata from the forest, but he not accept any food, but still have time to eat. Then he invite to that bhikkhu and he offer the his rice packet. Okay, this is a, suddenly he done this kusala. He not preparing before, not think before. The same way, one day, usually the king, if he want to travel the country or city, he change his cloth, no? He change his life, just he got a normal person, no? One day he went to the city. At that time, two bhikkhu also coming Pindapata. Nobody offer food. At that moment, he sell his two slippers, he found the two rice packet and offer. This two kusala, he catch the near dead moment. He caught the near dead moment. Why? From beginning, middle, end of this kusala, very pure. Very pure. But when he built the Mahacheti, during the construction, so many happening. He not cannot continuously keep in the good mind. Sometimes he have to fight with the workers, so many things happen. That's why if he want to do the kusala from beginning, middle, end with pure, this is a very good kusala. Then because of that, he reborn in the Deva world. He is a great right disciple of the Maitreya Buddha in future. Yeah. He is the great like Pandita Sariputta. Just like Sariputta. I want to explain that you are doing the kusala, you try to do it with pure mind and with the concentration mind. This is a wholesome, okay? If you do the non-wisdom, means the without knowledge, you cannot get the good result in future. Maybe you can reborn again human world, but no more wisdom. Then, who has two-rooted mind, he cannot meditate, he cannot enter the jhana, he cannot practice vipassana, he cannot reach to nibbana also. That's why we have to cultivate three-rooted consciousness. Okay, you can understand, no? The same way, the resultant also. Resultant, also there are eight. According to our birth linking moment and bhavanga, etc. Functional consciousness for arahat, for the Buddha and for the arahat, for the great noble person. Okay, now the 24 consciousness that we can, they have the chart. Sense sphere, karma, which are beautiful consciousness, they are 24, they make the three categories. The great wholesome and great resultant and great functional. Okay? Okay? Okay. Now the rupa, fine material sphere consciousness. There are 15. 5 wholesome, 5 resultant and 5 function. This is a jhana mind. This is what we call jhana mind. When we are practicing anapana method or kasina method, at that time you can reach to the first jhana, second jhana, third jhana, fourth jhana and fifth jhana. There are 5 jhana, no? This 5 jhana is a 5 kusala. This is a 5 kusala. First jhana is a first kusala of fine material. Second jhana is a second kusala. Third jhana is a third kusala. Fourth jhana is a fourth kusala. Fifth jhana is a fifth kusala. Okay? This one, if someone want to get experience, what we have to do? We have to meditate diligently. Not enough few minutes a day per day. Not enough one sitting a day. We should practice diligently. At least 3 months, 4 months, continuously. Okay? May you try. Okay, this is resultant also. If someone practicing jhana, if any jhana consciousness near the dead moment, because of that, he can reborn in the Brahma world. This resultant mind arises in the Brahma world. This is Brahma, there are 16, the places, no? 16 places of in the Brahma world. There are 16 Brahma world. No, those are 16, we can make the first jhana level, second jhana level, third jhana level, fourth jhana level. According to the jhana, wholesome jhana, we can get the resultant, we can reborn in the Brahma world. This is a resultant. For the functional, for the arahat, for the Buddha. Lord Buddha also practicing, attain jhana, no? Same arahat also, attain jhana. At that time, realizing only functional mind, no more result. The fine material, sphere, consist, rupa, avachara, vipaka, and already explained, no? Okay. They have the chart. You can check by yourself. Okay, anyway, the first, second, third, fourth jhana is happiness. Last one, not happiness. Fifth one is equanimity. Equanimity. The immaterial sphere consciousness, there are 12. There are 4 kusala, there are 4 vipaka, 4 kiriya. Okay. If someone want to get immaterial jhana, okay, this is immaterial jhana, he should practice kasina first. One of the 9 kasina. There are 4 element kasina, 4 element kasina, and 4 color kasina, one of light kasina. There are 9 kasina object. Then first of all, you have to reach to the 5th jhana, the fine material jhana. After that, you can go into the immaterial jhana. They have the way. We have to go systematically. We cannot jump. Without practicing fine material jhana, you cannot go to the immaterial. You cannot get the immaterial jhana consciousness. Okay? You have to go step by step. Without practicing the first jhana, you cannot reach the second. Without practice first and second, you cannot reach the third. Same way, you have to go systematically. This is a Buddha's teaching. Okay? But one day, after successful, you are 8 kasina, the 4 element and 4 color kasina. When you are skillful, the 8 kasina, at that time, you can jump. You can jump. This is what we call, we are practicing if someone wants to practice abhinya, second power. At that time, we have to jump. First to third, third to fifth, like this, we have to jump. They have the way. But without skillful, the 8 kasina, we cannot go. We cannot do anything. Okay? We have to practice one by one every day. Okay? Anyway, the dosa kusala for the this life we can reach to kusala, and result arise in the immaterial world. Okay? They have after 16 Brahma world, they have the immaterial world. The resultant appearing there, and then functional arising for the arahat, for the Buddha and Paccheka Buddha and arahat. They have the chart also. All are immaterial consciousness accompanied with equanimity. No any happiness there. No more happiness. Okay. important part, supermundane consciousness, Lokottara. Why we are doing kusala? Why we are coming here? Why we are meditating? Why we are studying Dhamma? Because of what? What is the reason? To reach to Nibbana. Actually, really we have the mind, I want to get Nibbana, I want to get free from suffering, I want to get free from old age, I want to get free from sickness. Then we have the mind, I want to get the peaceful and calm mind. Means the I want to reach to Nibbana. Then because of Nibbana object arising, there are 8 type of consciousness only arising. Because of Nibbana object arising, 8 type of consciousness. According here. According to, because the, but usually the, who reached to Nibbana, he also can, when he reflects to Nibbana, that arises in the wholesome mind, sense sphere wholesome mind. But my means, the, because of Nibbana object arising, supermundane consciousness. Now, there are 8, 4 wholesome and 4 resultant. Sotapatti magga, path consciousness of stream entry. Same way, sakadagami, one return. Anagami, none return. Arahata, arahachi. Okay? The same way, lokotripaka, fruition consciousness of stream entry. One return, none return, and arahachi. Okay, now the briefly explain 89, but the 8 type of supermundane consciousness, we can, with the details, there are 40. There are how many? 40 consciousness. 8 become 40. How? Example, without jhana mind, we cannot reach to the supermundane. Supermundane consciousness all the time arises with the jhana mind. But that's the jhana, not the fine material jhana. Not the immaterial jhana. This is we call supermundane jhana. But they also have the jhana factors, same as before. We explain. First jhana, second jhana, third jhana, fourth jhana, fifth jhana. Okay? Then this way, if someone reached to Sotapatti Magga, when he get the Sotapatti Magga, at that moment sometimes Sotapatti Magga can arise with first jhana. Sotapatti Magga can arise with second jhana. Same way, third jhana, same way, fourth jhana, fifth jhana. Now become five consciousness. Sotapatti become 5 consciousness. Same way, one return also 5, none return also 5, arahashi 5, become 20. 20 path consciousness, 20 fruition consciousness, become 80. Okay? 40, yeah, sorry, 40. The 20 for the wholesome of the supermundane, 40 fruition of, so 20 fruition of supermundane consciousness. Total become 40. Okay? Okay, anything else? Yeah? Oh, because the fine material jhana arises with the concept. Object is a different object, concept, panyati. Okay? The supermundane jhana arises with the nibbana object. Nibbana. It's object different. Yeah. Of course, because the first, second, third, fourth happiness, last one equanimity. But the difference, it could object, okay, object, and even the another thing. The when the lokottara jhana arising, the same moment they cut off the definements. It's important. The when the sotapatti magga arise, the magga moment can destroy the some fetters. There are three types of fetters: the sanyojana, the sakkaya ditti, wrong view of itself, vichikicca, doubt, silabbata paramas, one kind of the wrong view for the equal of the practice, no? Yeah, there are three type of the fetters can cut off. But in the first jhana moment, the fine material, first jhana moment, they cannot cut off the defilement, but they can suppress the five hindrance only. Five hindrance. Okay? This is different. They have a very big gap between the fine material and supermundane jhana. They have a very... Okay? But the fine material jhana moment, only temporarily they are controlling the defilement. But supermundane jhana moment, they are totally cut off the defilement. Okay? And someone practice fine material jhana, but later, if he not continuously practice, very easy drop of the jhana. Very easy drop. But someone reached to sotapatti, he never dropped again to the human, to the mundane world. He never again dropped. His life is a permanent, and he never come back. He turn back. Okay. They are different, many things are between.
What's the difference between mundane path formation and mundane path formation?
Mundane, yes, mundane. No. Mundane don't have. Mundane, we call the wholesome, unwholesome, resultant, functional. Only super mundane, they have path and fruition. Only super mundane, no, don't have mundane. Oh, but you mean the but eightfold path we can divide. Eightfold path, they have the mundane eightfold path, super mundane eightfold path. But the consciousness we cannot divide. Path knowledge and fruition knowledge only for super mundane world, not the mundane world. Okay. Anything else? Because now the if you know the 89. Or 121 consciousness, then if you can manage by your mind, that means the can count or can the image. Okay, if you can image, then I can go to the third chapter, our original lesson. Because those are 89 consciousness, we are going to make the group, different group, according to the third chapter. Okay? Now the compendium of miscellaneousness means the pakinaka, the miss, altogether miss. But actually, we already explained before, during the first chapter, 81, so 89, no, 121 citta. The chapter, under chapter 2, we already explained 52 chetasika and including citta, 53 mental factors. So the mentality, we already explained. Now the chapter 3rd, also, we will deal concisely with his classification by way of feelings, roots, functions, dose, object, and basis. Okay, this is under the third chapter. those are 89 or 121 consciousness. We are going to make the group according to feelings, Vedana, roots, Hetu, functions, Kicca, those, Dwara, object, Arammana, basis, Vattu. Okay? Now the first one, about according to Vedana, a compendium of feelings, Vedana, analyzing of feeling according to the Sutta, according to the Abhidhamma, you can see the some Sutta coming from Sanyutta, Vedana Sanyutta, coming from Sanyutta Nikaya, explaining there are two types of feeling, mental feeling and physical feeling, kaika and chetasika. This is mainly two feelings, mental and physical. Do you have any experience about feeling? Yes, every day, every time, no? Now also have experience. We cannot sit longer in the one posture. We have to change. We have knee pain, back pain, sometimes headache, many things. Okay. That is the physical pain. Because of physical pain, sometimes mental also pain. Yeah, there are two types of pain. But later, in the sutta also, you can see this mental pain, we can divide into three categories. There are three feelings. What are the three? The namely we call there are three kind of feeling, namely pleasant, happiness, painful means tomanasya, and neither painful nor pleasant. This is the equanimity. This is the mental feeling. We can make the three categories: somanasya, happiness, tomanasya, non-happiness, Opekka, equanimity. Okay? The body feeling, physical feeling, we can make the two. Sometimes painful and sometimes joyful. If you can find the comfortable seat, very comfortable, you're happy. Yeah? The joyful pain. But you cannot get the comfortable seat. This is physical. The pain. Okay? But anyway, they have explained the by the effective qualities, their fault. The pleasant sukha, painful dukkha, neither painful nor pleasant, adukkama sukha. By governing faculty, indriya, fivefold pleasure, sukha, pain, dukkha, joy, somanasa, displace, domanasa, equanimity, upekka. Okay? Now, again, they have threefold and fivefold analyzing of feeling. Analyzing. Sukha means the happiness, the happy feeling, bodily and mentally. You understand? Dukkha, bodily and mentally. Adukkam sukha is equanimity. Okay, now, if someone want to know the details about the feeling, they are explaining according to characteristic, function, manifestation, and proximate causes. Okay? Actually, I'm not going to explain this one quite deep, but you can understand. You try to, but especially the dosa thing can see that after the meditators can practice during the meditation moment. Okay, by example, now when you enter the jhana, at that time you want to see the feeling, happiness, then you can investigate. According to the characteristic, according to the functions, etc. Then, but anyway, you try to get the meaning. Now the sukha, the sukha, somanasa, dukkha, domanasa, upekkha, there are five feelings. Okay, now according to the feeling, how we divide our consciousness? Okay, now this is important. Classification by way of consciousness. This is important. This is a now 89 consciousness. We have to divide. We have to know about the feeling. How many painful consciousness? How many body joyful consciousness? How many mental happiness consciousness? How many mental suffering consciousness? How many equanimity consciousness? Okay? You can count? Because now you have the chitta chart. Already have chitta notes. You can count. But easy way, how many body pain consists only one? How many body joyful consists only one? How many mental suffering consists? There are two. Hatred mind. Two hatred mind. Then others, rest. Rest consciousness, we can make the two group, happiness and mental happiness and equanimity. Okay? Now the according to this chart, they're explaining sukha. Of them, wholesome resultant body consciousness in the only one accompanied by pleasure. Do you remember? One of the rootless. One of the rootless consciousness. Actually that one, wholesome resultant. One of the wholesome resultant consciousness. If you can get the body conscious in the joyful body with pleasure, this is your good kusala. Sometimes, if you can get the good place for sitting, if you can sleep in the good bed, if you can get the good thing for the body, this is your good kusala. But you see now in the Africa, many poor people, they cannot, no place for the seat, no place for the sleep. They're very poor and they're not sit and sleep comfortably. This is a dukkha. This is akusalipaka. If you can get the good place for bodily joy, the accompanied by the pleasure with the body, mind, this is your kusalipaka. Same way, understand. Unwholesome resultant body consciousness in the only one accompanied by pain. Okay? Accompanied by pain. Okay, now the three, and then domanas. They are, domanas later, no? Okay, better check the domanas, the last one. Only the two types of consciousness connected with dosa. They are accompanied by displeasure. Actually, the mental suffering, every time the mental suffering arises because of the hatred, because of the no good object, because of the bad object, because of the bad reason. Okay, now the rest. Or rest consciousness, we can make the somanasa and upekkha. Now see the somanasa, there are 62 kind of consciousness accompanied by joy. Namely, I can give the name here, but later you have to mark by yourself in the chitta notes, okay? You have to find the different color pen or the highlight, you have to mark for the understand. There are 18 types of sense fear consciousness. Okay, how many sense fear consciousness? 54. Okay, now among the 54, there are 18 consciousness are happiness, mental happiness. What are the 18? four rooted in greed, loba, four type of loba mind. 12 type of sense fear, beautiful consciousness. There are 12 of sobana, four kusala, four resultant and four functional. Same way, the two rootless types, joyful investigating and smiling consciousness. Okay, there are 18. Okay. The number B, there are 44 types of sublime, sublime, no? And supermundane consciousness pertaining to the first, second, third, and fourth jhanas. Now remember, I told you, no? First, second, third, fourth jhana is happiness. Last one is not happiness, equanimity. Now, how many first jhana? According to the sublime, means the mahagata. Mahagata is the first jhana in the fine material. There are three, no? One is kusala, one is resultant, one is a function. There are three. The same way, supermundane, there are eight. You understand? Okay. Total 11. The same way, second jhana is 11, third also 11, fourth also 11. Total become 44. Okay. 18 plus 44 become 62. And if someone want to count the consciousness according to the threefold of feeling, okay, then the 62 plus one body joyful consciousness, it becomes 63. Okay, becomes 63. Sometimes we have to count this way also. Okay, because now there are two types of feeling, no? There are three types of feeling and five types of feeling. Okay, we have to combine together. Upekkha. All are remaining 55 type of consciousness are accompanied by equanimity. What are the 55? There are 6 type of unwholesome consciousness. 4 rooted in greed, the lobha mula, and 2 delusion. 14 rootless consciousness. You have to count by yourself. I'm not going to give the details. Okay? 12 type of sense fear, beautiful consciousness. There are for each wholesome, result and functional. Then, three chitta of the fifth jhana in the fine material. In immaterial, there are 12 consciousness and 8 type of supermundane consciousness. Okay? There are 55. Now, they have the summary. Feeling, they are in the threefold, namely pleasure, the pleasure, pain and equanimity together with joy and displeasure, it is the fivefold. Okay, pleasure and pain are each found in one, displeasure in two, joy in 62, and they are remaining in equanimity 55. Counting of chitta according to the two feeling. Okay, now you see, somanasa o sukha saha, they are 63. How become 63? 62 minus plus 1 body joyful. Okay. And there are 3. How become 3 domanas? Mental, 2 suffering, 1 of the body pain. Upekkha, there are 55. Total 121. O, somanas, mental happiness, there are 62. Body happiness, there are 1. Mental suffering, there are 2. Body pain, there are 1. Equanimity, 55. Total, 121. Okay, today is a lesson quite easy. But tomorrow's is okay. After that, I also don't know how to explain quite deep. Because the Dwara and Aramana are quite deep, but may I try to explain it smoothly? Yeah? Because so many thing inside. Because you this way you have to, first you should skillful, there are 89 consciousness. It's more important, no? Because the second one is also quite okay, second lesson, but third, two, and fourth, quite deep. The deep means that we have so many detail inside. If someone is skillful, the 89 consciousness, then can understand. Can they explain, can understand, okay? Anything else? Okay. Sadhu, sadhu, sadhu. Idam me punyam. Asavakkaya. Vahang hotu. Idam me punyam. Nibbanas. Pachayo. Hotu. Mama punya bhagang. Sabba satanang. Bhajemi te sabbe me samang punya bhagang labhantu sadhu sadhu sadhu.